Hello, my name is Chris Woodward, and this is part two of the ArangoDB Graph Syntax video tutorial series. In this video, we will take a look at using the filter keyword with graph traversals in AQL, the ArangoDB Query Language. See the description for a link to part one, where I walk through the fundamental syntax for doing a graph traversal with AQL. In this tutorial, we will use the airport and flights dataset to help us book a flight. The link for that data is available in the description. The airports collection contains documents with all of the airport location information, as well as a VIP attribute which indicates whether or not the airport has a VIP lounge. The documents in the flights collection contain flight-specific information. For this video, we will be interested in the underscore from and underscore to fields, which are the departure and arrival locations for the flight, the month and day of their departure, and the times of the flight. Today, we will solve the problem of needing to book a flight for a much-needed vacation. Destination: Hawaii. The filter syntax is fairly simple. All that you must do is supply the filter keyword followed by your condition. The condition must evaluate to either true or false. If it is false, the element is skipped, and the query moves on to the next element. You may also make use of all AQL operators to evaluate each element. Now, let's use the filter keyword to help locate the flight to Hawaii. The current flight plan is it needs to depart from San Francisco, and the destination is Hawaii, and it needs to have one of those nice VIP lounges. Why not start the trip with a little style, right? I'll build this query in the web view that is bundled with the ArangoDB installation. With filter statements, you have the option of providing multiple conditions per filter statement, or you may write your conditions using multiple filter statements. Let's take a look at an example of using multiple filter statements. To find a VIP airport in San Francisco, it is possible to use the condition with a logical AND, which is either the double ampersand or the AND keyword. Alternatively, as a way to split up the conditions and keep them easy to read, AQL allows for simply using another filter statement. The ArangoDB Query Optimizer combines these two filter statements with a logical AND, as if they were one statement. The statement returns one result, the San Francisco International Airport. After using the filter statements to narrow down the starting airport, it is time to find that flight to Hawaii. This can be accomplished using a graph traversal. The destination is the Kona region of Hawaii because they are known for growing some amazing coffees in that region. The local airport is Kona International Airport. To build the graph traversal, we will use another for loop, this time the graph variant. It will emit the edge, vertex, and path because we can filter on each variable if needed. To find a direct flight, supplying the depth of 1.1 will get all the flights that only include one flight from San Francisco to Kona International. We supply the outbound keyword to indicate we want flights leaving San Francisco. This would be underscore from San Francisco and underscore to Kona International. Now, supply the airport variable from the first for loop that matches the initial criteria of VIP in San Francisco as our starting vertex. Next, use the flights collection as the edges of the graph. This is where the first filter statement of the graph traversal comes in. Applying a filter statement to the vertex variable in a graph traversal tells the query to find a vertex that matches the condition that we specify. So only the last vertex in the traversal path needs to match this condition. Airport/KOA is the underscore ID for our destination airport. Returning the P or path variable returns the full flight plan, which contains the starting airport document, the connecting flights edges document, and the destination airport document. Running this query shows the edges and vertices that connect the San Francisco airport vertex to the Kona International Airport vertex. It looks like there are actually some non-stop flights to Kona International. Although there is only one line, the results actually contain 30 flights, as indicated here, where it shows 30 elements. The full JSON results are also viewable by clicking on the JSON button in the top right of the results screen. Because the path was returned and the path contains all of the vertices and edges from start to finish, the web view is able to show this interactive visualization. However, as you may know, direct flights usually come with a hefty price tag, and showing the immediately connected nodes also doesn't take full advantage of using a graph database. Setting the minimum to 2 and changing our maximum to 3 means that the results contain only flights that at a minimum have one layover and at maximum have 2 layovers to get to Kona International. To start getting some flights that are a bit more affordable, simply increasing the depth of the traversal is a logical step. However, when traversing a graph, it is important to take into account the number of potential results. Just increasing the depth would result in a query that needs to traverse every single flight that leaves San Francisco, and then do the same for every flight that leaves the connected airport to find out if that flight goes to Kona International, which can be an expensive operation depending on the dataset. The answer to this problem will be dependent on your dataset and individual application. Making the query more selective, creating indexes to cover your queries, and limiting the number of results are definitely good places to start. For this query, including a specific date for departure would make sense. The path variable contains an array named edges that has all of the flights for the trip. This statement adds the criteria that the flight should leave on the third day of the first month, so January 3rd. This condition is using an array operator and array expansion. See the links for more information on array operators in the description. In order to continue increasing the depth of this query, it becomes necessary to start limiting the number of results returned. Using the limit keyword followed by the number 10 here limits the number of results traversed and returned to 10. This means that 10 full flight plans are returned for us to choose from. The first time you run this query, it may still take a few seconds. This is due to how RocksDB's storage engine retrieves and caches data. Please see the links in the description for more information on query performance. The results of this query currently do not ensure that the first plane lands before the next one takes off. Kind of a problem. We will use the date_add keyword, which allows for adding time to a date, to add 20 minutes to the landing time, and then make sure that this time is still before the next plane departs. Furthermore, since the results can contain up to 3 edges, it is important to actually add a second filter statement that checks the same thing, but for the second and third flight. There are many date-specific keywords that are available with ArangoDB, and I have provided a link in the description with more information. These results match the criteria of our original flight plan. It departs on January 3rd from San Francisco, which has a VIP lounge, and lands at Kona International. Additionally, we confirm that our plane lands before the next one takes off, so we won't miss any flights. Hopefully, you can now see that applying filters in a graph traversal can help retrieve some very useful results. To learn more about graph traversals, check out our graph course, which takes you from absolute zero knowledge about graphs in ArangoDB to advanced graph queries using the ArangoDB query language. Now that we have found a flight, though, it's time for me to start packing. Please leave a comment with any feedback and be sure to like this video and subscribe to this channel to get notified about upcoming videos from ArangoDB.